Her tweet said that she's working. I'll believe her.
Yeah.
She's probably working on something.
Working.
Yeah. Have you seen Guardians of the Galaxy?
No, I haven't seen it. It's my sin. I thought I'd be able to watch it on the plane, but
no!
It wasn't on the plane.
Don't watch it on a plane. Go to the theater.
Go to the theater. I need to see it.
Yes.
I do need to see Blue Moon Karen. Yeah. Shaved her head and looks more like the moon.
And before we go to the floor, what's it like, you know, in Toronto? Is this your first time at a Toronto convention?
First time in Canada.
You guys clap anything.
Just placing. Canada! Montreal!
That's amazing.
Wow. Churros!
Don't do Bieber though, that
no. What were you chair?
Just to make things awkward up here, who's the better person to work with, David Tennant or Matt Smith?
Oh.
I'm kidding.
I'll make
you answer
that one. Neither of them anyway. Yeah, I never talked to either of them. It's difficult. It's difficult me and Matt are both here this weekend because we really have beef. Yeah. There may be a fight.
Well,
when we do our panel tomorrow.
Yeah.
And we're going to wrestle. Hulk Hogan's here. I'm really excited about that. It was years of me beating up the cushions on my parents' sofa when I was, 16. When I was like 7. I just want him to power slam. I want him to pick me up and throw me through a window. He won't. He's a gentleman.
I don't know if he's been doing much wrestling lately.
Is he not?
I don't know.
Inwardly. You never know. You don't know what people got going on in their minds.
Well, I did want to ask you, related to Broadchurch, you know, how do you transition from being on a show with such whimsy like Doctor Who to working on something that's certainly a lot more serious like Broadchurch?
Yeah, it's really great, actually. It's funny because obviously Chris Chibnall, who writes Broadchurch, also wrote a lot of Doctor Who, so this, you know, he has his stamp on everything. He's so good, but it's really nice to do something which is, I'm a big fan of variety in my career and life, and get kind of quite bored easily. So it's really nice to have really good scripts to work on and to be able to do something different. But yeah, it's really hard, actually. We're filming series 2 at the moment, and is that you just clapping the number 2? Yeah, which is going really well. I'm not allowed to talk about it, so I won't. But yeah, the scripts are great. It's great just doing stuff which is really quite, you know, very, very, very serious. It's hard stuff. But yeah, they on the set of Broadchurch at the moment, so Jodie Whittaker, who's in it with me, found out that this is a long story, sorry. So my mom, let's go back, my mom, as a joke for Christmas 2 years ago, gave my grandma a cardboard cutout of me from Doctor Who, saying that you never see him, and you always shout at him when you do, so this can be in your house, and you just shout at the cardboard cutout of me. And when Nan opened it on Christmas Day, I was like, oh, gosh, this is ridiculous. And I started laughing, and I found it hilarious, but also kind of embarrassing. And my nan just went, why are you laughing? And I was like, oh, stupid. It's not stupid. It's beautiful. Which is great. And then she put it up. And went, well, then your legs are Matt's. Now, I don't know why she thought that the legs of the cardboard cutout could possibly be Matt. And also, it's the only time she'd ever called him Matt, she used to call him Dan. So Jodie Whittaker found out about this and bought the cardboard cutout and put it in my trailer. So when I opened the door of my trailer, I was scared by thinking there was someone in there and actually it was me. It's done the rounds. People keep putting it in other people's dressing rooms, toilets. It ended up in Olivia Colman's hotel room. And then I saw someone throwing it out of their trailer the other day, and they found it in two pieces near the bins, which was quite awesome. Yeah. So that's what's happening on Broadchurch. It's hard work.
All right, well, let's go to the floor. If you got a question, just throw up your hand, and then I'll have you shout it out. If I can't hear you, I'll reiterate it. I saw one right here in the front row, so let's go there first.
Hi, Alpha.
Hey.
So my question is relating to your music. If you could collaborate with anyone who's currently alive, who would you like to collaborate with?
Oh, wow.
Did everyone hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who didn't hear it?
President.
That's a really good question. Musically, there's so many amazing people. I've just watched, Kate Bush is doing gigs in London at the moment, and I haven't been able to see them because the ticket's sold out in about 9 seconds. But I think she's amazing. So, Kate Bush, Tom York is brilliant. Justin Bieber. Yeah. You'd be great to collaborate with Justin Bieber because you can just make him, you know, make him bray like a donkey or something. Something experimental, I think, just really stretching your... That's the dream, isn't it? Arcade Fire, VMAs. They're playing tonight. It's fun. Other people.
Can you think of any... lesser-known artists or indie artists that you want to give a little shout-out to that you're a fan of?
Yeah, there are... you guys probably know most of them. Five. That's good. There's a guy you should... Thanks for answering my question. Get put on the spot. I'm going to employ you just to be my other friend. This guy called Fife Dangerfield is brilliant, who I used to play guitar for. And he's in a band who don't really play anymore called Guillemots. So look at them, they're brilliant. There's a guy called Baxter Jury in London who's great, and he's Ian Jury's son from Ian Jury and the Podcast, and he's really good. And there's a band called Cold Specs, who are great as well. But have you written these down? You're testing me later.
We'll go back to the crowd for more.